Ducati on a run of three wins on the trot. If they make it four today, that will be a record for the Bologna manufacturer. Not even Casey Stoner managed four on the trot.
Well, this man is backing himself to make that soft front tyre work again. He's backing his famed, his hailed, silky smooth riding style to not overheat that front tyre, not overwear it as he gets down to a hot pace early on. Provisional tyre sheet definitely indicates that Lorenzo, as we expected, he did the whole of FP4 and the whole of this morning's warm-up session with that soft front tyre. I would be gobsmacked if this man isn't going hard, hard.
Mark Marquez has had a couple of tumbles in the last 24 hours. He crashed in free practice four, and he crashed this morning in warm-up as well. Valentino Rossi just in the distance there makes his way onto the grid.
Quite unusual to see Marc Marquez walking off the grid once he's come to it. He is determined to end this Ducati domination of the MotoGP World Championship. He'd love nothing more than to do it here in front of his home crowd in Aragon. Simon?
Guys, I'm on the third row of the grid with Danilo Petrucci. Danilo, what do you think is going to be the most difficult things to manage in this race?
Tire heating is very, very hard. I mean, after five, six laps, the tire became very hot, especially in the left side of the tire. And the most difficult thing is to manage this. For me, it's even more difficult. I weigh 10 kilos more, average. And we'll see. But for sure, the key is to become the first lap, but it will be not easy.
Thank you, Danilo.
Yeah, thanks very much to Danilo Petrucci there for talking to Simon. He had a tough time out at his home Grand Prix in Misano last time, did Petrucci. But he's only had one DNF all year. He has been consistently in the points. He's eighth overall, of course, third in that independent team championship.
Here's Dani Pedrosa then, just six races away from calling time on his illustrious career, the 32-year-old. Spanish rider, a winner here back in 2012. He was runner-up to Casey Stoner in both 2010 and 2011. Second in 2015 after an epic late fight with Valentino Rossi. Sixth here last year, that's where he starts today's race, on that second row with Cal Crutchlow and Andrea Iannone. Six in qualifying yesterday. His best performance since Jerez 10 races ago. Another front tyre change coming here for Andrea Iannone. He was definitely initially on the allocation for a soft front, and then Simon did say he changed to the medium. So we expect Andrea Iannone to start the race on the medium. We'll keep you posted on that one. Here's Alex Rins, his teammate. Well, this is a home race for him. Born and bred about 20 minutes away. Simon?
Yeah, guys, I'm now with Jack Miller. Jack, I was just with your teammate, Danilo, and he said tyres is going to be the hardest thing to manage for this one. What do you think?
Yeah, 100%, especially with the heat we've got now and also all of that rubber that's down on the track. So I think not to get too overly excited in the first laps is going to be the key thing, which it should be the key thing for me, especially after last week. But now we'll try and manage them the best we can until there's some Michelin rubber down, and you know the track normally comes to you about halfway through the race, so hopefully you know we got enough left on the tyres to try and make some moves there.
Best of luck, Jack.
Yeah, one of the questions is going to be what happens in those opening laps, because that is going to be the danger zone. Marc Marquez then makes his way back onto the grid. There is Danilo Petrucci, who we just spoke to a moment ago.
Yeah, he's only had one point scoring finish here in Aragon in six previous races, never had a top 10, 11th in 2014. He's getting some last minute instructions from rider coach Fonzi Nieto, who we've just seen out on that Energica Eva Corsa FIM NL Moto E World Cup machine. A demo lap from Nieto. Back to the day job now, though. That's Petrucci and Jack Miller's rider coach. Simon.
I'm just trying to get out of everyone's way here. I'm now with Alvaro Bautista. And Alvaro, you've been on form yet again, but this time it's your home race. How are you feeling?
Yeah, for sure I feel so strong, no? Because I think we made a solid weekend, and now it's time for the race, no? For sure we'll be really hard because the temperature is so high. And our target is try to make with the start, try to stay with the front group, and yeah, we'll see what happens, no? But today we can enjoy the race and we can make good results.
Good luck, Alvaro.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks to Simon, thanks to Álvaro Bautista. He comes into this Aragon round in really, really good form. Top tens in seven in a row for the first time in 5 years. Ninth in five of the last seven. If we wanted to improve on that, will Álvaro Bautista score points in every single one of his appearances here in Aragon, including seven top tens, the best of which was a brilliant fourth place in 2013, just a tenth of a second behind Valentino Rossi in a pretty titanic battle for the podium that day.
Dovizioso looking for three wins in his last four races, looking for a record to break of his own. Four podiums on the trot would be for Andrea Dovizioso. And looking to try and cut that gap down, just to try and apply any pressure he can to Marc Marquez. Jorge Lorenzo now gets himself into the zone ahead of, and a very important race indeed from pole position after the crash in Misano. Simon.
Guys, I've come to talk to Jordi Torres, because Jordi, I really would like to hear your thoughts. What's it like to ride a Ducati MotoGP bike and be on the grid in the home race?
Yeah, it's amazing, no? Being here in my home, also my debut in MotoGP is amazing. It's a different riding style. It's completely opposite to the riding style that I'm habituated. But anyway, I fight to learn, and maybe if I can follow on the race, during the race, someone is better for me to continue to learn.
Can you tell me what is so different on these?
Yeah, of course, the most different is on the tire, also on the riding style. This kind of tires is very hard, and you don't have too much feedback about on your hands to understand what happened on the entry corner, on the fast corner, also to turn, because with this kind of bike, you reach to take a lot of angle. I am not habituated. In the opposite, in the World Superbike, the tires are, the carcass are more soft, and you have a lot of information. You try also to squeeze the tires everywhere.
Thank you, Jordi.
Thank you.
Great character, Jordi Torres.
Yeah, great to listen to him, of course, affectionately known as the Spanish Elvis. Some interesting news emerging from Michelin down on the grid. It looks like now Jorge Lorenzo will be the only man starting on that soft front tire. We know that he loves it, but there are late modifications going on down the grid as we speak. Álvaro Bautista initially went for that soft front slick. He's changed. He's gone up to a medium. Iannone did the same. And the man who we just spoke to, Jordi Torres, he was banking on racing that soft front tire. He's gone to the medium as well. Lorenzo out on a limb, maybe. Simon.
Now I'm with Bradley Smith. Brad, the KTM guys I spoke to this morning, your bosses, I was really proud of what you've been doing, especially in the situation, you know. And, you know, 1 second faster than last year. How does it feel for you?
Yeah, I'm just glad that the whole weekend's gone better than even I expected. I struggled here a lot last year, as you said, and yeah, I've managed to turn it around. The test that we had a month ago certainly helped me get up to speed. We're playing the long game, you know, hard. I've done it on FB2, FB4, and then we're going to do it again now. So at least I know what I have underneath me. I'm not the fastest guy out there, but I feel that the consistency is there with the KTM. So another good start from myself, and let's see how this 22 lap one pays out.
Best of luck, Brad.
Thank you.
Yeah, just tell him it's 23, not 22 laps. We don't want him pulling in a lap early. But here is Valentino Rossi then. Things have been a real struggle for Valentino of late, and he starts 17th on the grid. Matt was rolling out the stats earlier about the last time he was as far back down on the grid as that. We're not expecting him to finish down in 17th, of course, but a top 10, I suppose, it's probably about the best he can hope for today, Matt.
Yeah, salvaging a top 10, I think, probably the best that Valentino Rossi can hope for. It's been a really humbling experience for him this weekend. Of course, it was here last year at this very race where just 24 days after breaking his right leg, he came and produced a truly heroic performance, fifth place from the front row. I'm not quite sure he's going to be able to repeat that fifth place here today, even though he's in much more peak physical condition.
Here is Bradley Smith then. Of course, he just had a word with Simon Crafar, steering the ship solo once more, of course, after Pol Espargaró sadly crashed out and has rebroken that collarbone. We send Pol best wishes, of course, but KTM with so much to try, it's such a hammer blow for them.
Yeah, not for the first time this year. Bradley Smith, the lone warrior. Surgery on that damaged left collarbone yesterday in Barcelona for Pol Espargaró. It went well. We wish him a speedy recovery. Here's Franco Morbidelli, who qualified in 13th place yesterday, but he was penalised 6 grid places for impeding Bradley Smith, actually, at the end of the back straight in Q1. So Franco Morbidelli now marooned back in 19th place on the grid after that 6th place penalty.
Hafiz Sayarin has found it a real struggle of late. He's just lacking confidence in that front end and in general. 19th last time out in Misano. Of course, no points on offer for him in Austria either, and he's lost the lead of that rookie points. He's losing out to Taka Nakagami recently as well, just desperately on the hunt for some confidence before we head overseas and, of course, soon to his beloved home of Malaysia.
Well, we've got a real mixed bag in terms of tyre choices, but the one constant is it's either a soft rear tyre or a hard rear tyre. Nobody has gone for the medium. As I suspected, I spoke to Alex Rins actually on Friday, and he said the soft rear tyre, too soft.
Dovizioso wins the opening race. It's a hat-trick for Marc Marquez. It takes his third victory. It's double delight for Jorge Lorenzo. Here, that's going to be super, super tight. Oh, a massive moment there. Oh, how has he not gone down? Marc Marquez wins an accident. It's Ducati versus Honda. Dovizioso comes through. Dovizioso has taken the victory here in Brno. And here he comes now. Oh, they almost touch on the straight. Marquez again, another block pass. Lorenzo, yeah. Though, clever. Austria is Lorenzo land. We're ready in Rimini. Dovizioso up the inside of Marc Marquez.
Oh, typical Marc Marquez, a great win.
Brilliant drive here from Andrea Dovizioso, and he's got the inside line. Coming from Marc Marquez, he sits Lorenzo up.
Wow.
What a time to be on board with Jorge Lorenzo.
Oh, Lorenzo's down. Jorge Lorenzo's crashed out.
It is Dovi demolition here in Misano.
The big moment draws closer. The main event of the weekend. And the three big men, soft front, hard rear for Jorge Lorenzo as he starts from pole position.
He's backed himself to the hilt. He loves that soft front tyre. He made it work when he was victorious in Mugello and Barcelona.
67-point lead to defend for Marc Marquez. Dovizioso looking for back-to-back victories after his glory in Misano, and Jorge Lorenzo looking to make Aragon Lorenzo land once more.
MotoGP Mania hits Motorland. It's Aragon for round 14 of the 2018 MotoGP World Championship. Lorenzo in pole position for the third race in a row for 6 years. Andrea Dovizioso and Marc Marquez on that front row. Cal Crutchlow, Andrea Iannone and Dani Pedrosa, they round out row two. Petrucci, Bautista and Alex Rins on row three. Jack Miller, Taka Nakagami and Joan Zarco, the lead Yamaha in 12th. Aleix Espargaró, Maverick Viñales after that three-place penalty, 14th. They had a Bradley Smith on row five. Valentino Rossi way, way back on the middle of the sixth row in 17th place, sandwiched in between Carol Abraham and Hafiz Sayarin. Franco Morbidelli penalised sixth place yesterday. He's with his teammate Tom Lutie and Scott Redding on row seven. Xavier Simeon and his stand-in teammate, the two Reali of Inter Ducatis on the back row of the grid on row eight.
Boiling hot here in Spain, into the low 30s.
Mirror, mirror on the wall, who's going to be the fastest of them all here in Aragon today? 30 degrees ambient temperature, 45 degrees on track, hardly any breeze around to keep it cool. It's going to be a physically and mentally demanding 23 laps for the 23 strong field. On the domination here the last 2 years from this man, Marc Marquez, who is trying to avoid an unwanted record here today. If Marc Marquez finishes on the podium here today, it will be the fourth race in a row he's had a podium, but not taking it from the top step.
When Jorge Lorenzo had a corner named after him in Jerez, it didn't go quite to plan for him. And Marc Marquez got the better of him. could it be reversed here? 62,970 spectators here in Aragon. Let me tell you, it's not a circuit really for the massive grandstands because it follows the contours of the hills and stuff. That is a big crowd for Aragon.
Yeah, it's not the easiest place in the world to get to as well. So a fantastic crowd baking in the scorching hot conditions. Are they going to be treated to another super showdown between Lorenzo Dovizioso and Marc Marquez? Or can anybody further down the field, the likes of Cal Crutchlow and Danny Pedrosa? What about Álvaro Bautista sounding confident from eighth on the grid? What about Alex Rins, who showed so strongly last time out in Misano, going from ninth place? And what about the Yamahas? Can they rescue or salvage anything from what's been a demoralising and dejecting weekend for the Iwata factory?
Over in Brno, we had a fantastic race on our return from the summer break. Andrea Dovizioso victorious in a fantastic battle that involved this man, Jorge Lorenzo and Marc Marquez. Same again in Austria a week later, but Lorenzo was then on top of the pile. And same again last time out in Misano with Dovizioso winning. Ducatis have won the last three, they're looking for four, but Marc Marquez here is at home and he's had enough of these boys on Ducatis. He wants to try and spoil the Bologna party. Danny Pedrosa there just wheeling himself back into position. We are getting closer. We arrive here in Aragon and the green flag waves at the back as we get ready to start here in Aragon. Away from the line we go. It's a really good start from Marc Marquez in third. Someone from the second row got a good launch as well. But here comes Jorge Lorenzo. Has he done enough? Marquez up to second. In fact, he goes into the front. Lorenzo's gone down at turn one.
He's high-sided at the first corner. What a disaster for Jorge Lorenzo. He missed the whole shot from Marc Marquez and Jorge Lorenzo. He crashed out on the penultimate lap in Misano. He's dumped it on the first corner of the first lap here in Aragon. What drama!
I cannot believe what I'm seeing. Lorenzo, the favourite, is gone. Dovizioso it is that leads, and Andrea Iannone's already charged through on Marc Marquez and he's getting down and dirty. Simon?
I've just been told Marquez did a last-minute rear tyre change to soft.
Thanks very much for that. We'll monitor that one. Well, huge drama at turn one for Jorge Lorenzo. It is not to be a dream return to Aragon for him.
Well, he saw Marc Marquez pick his pocket on the run down to the first corner. Just over exuberance. Too aggressive was he on the throttle coming out of turn number one. He launched himself over the handlebars. He got a clattering from that Ducati GP18 on his back. It looked like he was briefly holding his leg. Now that's a sorry sight for Jorge Lorenzo. He did look at that lower right leg. He landed very heavily on his legs. That could be a nightmare for Jorge Lorenzo. His dreams of returning to the top step of the podium here in Aragon shattered on the very first lap.
Can you believe it? He's about to be informed, it's Marc Marquez, but I don't think he'll need to be. Well, here is Andrea Dovizioso then, down the back straight with Marquez in tow. The two factory Suzukis are then third and fourth with Danny Pedrosa and Aleix Espargaró in sixth place. Fantastic stuff there.
Can you believe it? When would have been the last time that Jorge Lorenzo qualified in two races on pole position and did not even see the checkered flag? Massive, massive moment. Marc Marquez straight away getting on his pit board. Jorge Lorenzo out of this Motorland Aragon race right here on the first lap. We're going to get a replay of it now. On the outside is Jorge Lorenzo.
He's too wide, he's offline, and he tries to get on the power too early. Simple as that.
Dirty part of the track. Look at the black line he leaves and a massive high side. Cal Crutchlow has got a front row seat for that one. Oh, he lands really heavily on his head. That is a horrible, horrible crash for Jorge Lorenzo on the number 99. And he landed heavily on that right leg as well. Stretching away Jorge Lorenzo. A sad sight. A disaster for Ducati.
Let's regroup then. Dovi is leading. We're on board of him. And there is Marc Marquez in second place from Iannone. Rins, who's moved up five places to fourth. Then it's Pedrosa, followed by Aleix Espargaró, up seven to six. In fact, Aleix Espargaró has just gone up into fifth place. An absolute ripper of a start for the number 41. He looked focused on the grid. Cal, of course, who had to take avoiding action, has dropped down a few places to eighth with Bautista up ahead of him.
Yeah, Bautista just running hard at the bottom of turn 12. That's cost him a couple of places. So it's Dovizioso being shadowed by Marc Marquez's Repsol Honda. Here they come out of turn number 15, the superior grunt, acceleration and top speed of that Ducati. He's not going to give Marc Marquez any chance of getting a slipstream. Look at the gap that Dovizioso could take. Bautista actually was wide at turn 12, and immediately after that, he's dumped it, so Bautista out. Bad day so far for a couple of the experienced Spaniards. Lorenzo and Bautista out before we've had two laps.
How critical will that soft tyre change last-minute.com from Marc Marquez be at the end of this one? They're both in the low 49s at this moment in time. As Alex Rins, great move into turn one on his teammate. Alex Rins, who was fourth last time out in Misano, is up to third, with Ian Ohmy now fourth here in Aragon.
Yamaha check. Joan Zarco 10th, Valentino Rossi 11th. Maverick Vinales, what on earth has happened to Vinales? He's languishing down in 18th place at the moment, not even anywhere near the points, Vinales.
This is what happened then to Alvaro Bautista. He's on a great run at the moment. Seven top tens on the spin, but not to be today. After the mistake earlier, he just washes out the front, I'm afraid, and that great run comes to an end here on home soil.
Yeah, he sounded quite confident of a top six challenge today as well, didn't he? They're ganging up behind Andrea Dovizioso. The gang being led by the hard-charging Marc Marquez through the corner that's just been named after him, turn number 10. And it's the two Suzukis. Alex Rins, who we know he's not scared of getting his elbows and knees out in a heated battle. He did it so brilliantly at the Dutch TT in Assen in early July, when there was, what, 175 overtakes in 40 minutes of breathless action.
Apologies to the cats and dogs watching for the high octaves into turn one, but that was dramatic. We just were not expecting that at all, as Ian Ohmy. Lovely up the inside of Alex Rins. The two Suzukis here chopping and changing, but they're having a good start.
Nice bit of sweet revenge. Look at that straight away. Andrea Iannone, I'm not too sure what Alex Rins will think about that. Well, he doesn't think much of it. Andrea Iannone giving a clear signal there to his teammate, somewhat cheekily, a tap on his butt cheek saying, stick behind me, let's not impede each other. And at the next corner, Alex Rins just sweeps straight underneath the Italian. The maniac will not be liking that. The maniac might be going a bit manic.
Good news, Danny Pedrosa fans. He's looking in a bit of form here. He's the fastest man on the track. Well, he was until Petrucci went through, runs wide. But Petrucci is just a couple of paces back. Look at Pedrosa here. He's right on the tail of the Suzukis. Could we see Danny back in form here on home soil?
Well, if the Aragon circuit had a roof, it would be raised if Danny Pedrosa was back on the podium. We've been wondering if there was any opportunities left for him to take one more podium or one more victory in his distinguished career. He's right in contention here. Alex Rins thought about having a look up the inside of Marc Marquez coming into turn seven. That's where Marquez took a tumble at 160 kilometres an hour in FP4 yesterday.
Dovizioso and Aragon have not really been a combination in the past that's worked out too well. Dovizioso never had a podium, not even had a top four on a Ducati here in this land. The last time he was on the podium here in Aragon was when he was with Tech 3 in 2012.
I remember that day, yeah. He had a right old ding-dong with his teammate Cal Crutchlow at the time. Here comes Alex Rins. He is really piling on the pressure, letting Marc Marquez know he's right there, glued to his rear tyre. Rins looking menacing here. He's born and bred about a 20-minute drive away from here, is the Spanish rider.
Aleix Espargaró really has done well to hang on in here. This is a fantastic effort from him on home soil. Cal Crutchlow still behind him, looking to regroup after what happened at turn one.
Yeah, the Rins family own a bakery in their local town. Well, in baking hot conditions, Alex Rins cooking up a bit of a storm here. He's trying to find a way through on Marc Marquez, still is unable to do so. But while he's having this great early rhythm, he's keeping his teammate Andrea Iannone at bay, who in turn has got Pedrosa and Crutchlow behind him.
He's got a great drive here. We're on board with Alex Rins. Thought about a look up the inside into turn one.
I'll tell you who's punching above their weight. It's Aleix Espargaró. He's just come over the line, a 149.083. Nothing at all this weekend to suggest that you're brilliant. Oh, this. Oh, Cal Crutchlow down.
And he is livid.
Second race in a row here in Aragon that Cal Crutchlow's perished. He's gone down the first corner as well, exactly where he was at a box office seat for Jorge Lorenzo's tumble on the first lap. So he's the third high profile casualty here in Aragon.
That's the third crash of the weekend for Cal Crutchlow. It's not been, in the end, a great show for Cal.
I was just going to say, Steve, Aleix Espargaró, he did a 149.083 on that last lap. Fastest lap of his race, fastest man on track, Aleix Espargaró. yesterday, I've never seen him so downbeat in my life. He was saying, well, maximum ambition was going to be a top 12, and there he is in sixth place.
This is the crash for Cal Crutchlow into turn one.
That went early.
Really early. We should just point out that race pace, though, is...
Marquez. That's Pedrosa's got
through Yannone. I thought that was Marquez for a moment.
I did for a split second. It's Pedrosa on Yannone, and Andrea Yannone says, well, you can take it back, mate. Anything you can give me, I'll give it you back. And so
the pace is a little slower than we expected. Well, in some ways.
Yeah, predicted race pace, 48.5. So we are a fair distance off that. We'll be getting close to that as the fuel load's lighted. And Pedrosa can't find his way through on Andrea Yannone. Let's not forget here last year in defence of Aleix Espargaró. I'm only saying that he's punching above his weight based on what we've seen so far from the Aprilia and what he said yesterday. Yesterday, Aleix Espargaró was saying he couldn't wait for the season to be over. He's not enjoying any aspect of racing right now. I bet he's enjoying this right in the heat of the battle for the top six in front of his home crowd.
Aleix Rins again, shadows a move into turn two. He's been told to change the mapping. Now that we're five laps into this one, on board with the world champion Marc Marquez, looking back to Rins and vice versa. Dovizioso it is that still commands the lead and still leads the train. Valentino Rossi is up in ninth now, ahead of Joan Zarco. Maverick Vinales has made a bit of progress, but only up to 15th.
You've got to take your hat off to Valentino Rossi. They always find that magic wand on a Sunday, don't they? He's just set his fastest lap of the race, Rossi, at 149.256. That was only bettered by the top three.
On board with the doctor now. Into the top 10, of course. Don't forget he started from 17th. There you can see the position progression for him. He's got Jack Miller now to try and hunt down, although Miller is a full second up the road.
Well, you can only fight with the tools you're given, and we know at the moment the Yamaha, it's a bit of a blunt weapon when you take it to a fight against Honda and Ducati, but Valentino Rossi extracting everything he can, every last ounce of performance out of that under pressure, struggling Wise RM1. Well, I'll tell you what, Marc Marquez was overloading that front tyre down in the turn 12.
Exactly what I was thinking, Matt. Ran really deep and late into turn 12 there, the number 93, but as ever he comes out smiling, onto the back straight we go, and look at that Ducati power. Marc Marquez cannot get close.
It's almost like it's sucking that 93 off Marc Marquez's fairing. It's just unrivaled in a straight line. It just goes into another dimension, that Ducati. Marc Marquez has talked about it so often this year. He says when they click fourth, fifth and sixth gear, it's like they hit a turbo button.
Shout out to Bradley Smith. He's pushed up to 11th place. Really good job from the Red Bull KTM rider. Petrucci's just started to join this group. We had a group of five. It's now a group of seven with Petrucci on the tail of Aleix Espargaró.
Can't speak highly enough of this ride so far by Aleix Espargaró in sixth place. Let's not forget, after the last race in Misano, he tried the 2017 RSGP, fell back in love with it, and pretty much demanded that he had one of those bikes available here. He thought the 2018 RSGP was so bad, he wanted to race last year's bike here this weekend. That was a request turned down to his disgust by Aprilia, but he's knuckled down, got his head down, and he's having by far his best ride of the season so far as Aleix Espargaró. Hats off to the guy.
Two factory Suzukis are having a really strong effort here. They're just keeping things steady. They're not doing too much with their tyres. The big question for both Rins and Iannone, as Rins gets it a bit wild, is going to be what happens at the halfway point when we expect to see the likes of Dovizioso and Marquez peeling away.
Bit loose, wasn't it, that rear tyre, as Rins was on the gas coming through turn number 11. We've already seen, he's been told by his team for that mapping change. Have the Suzukis already had to switch to a softer mapping? Have they already gone into tyre management mode? Aleix Rins at the moment putting up a real strong fight, keeping Marc Marquez more than very honest. He can't shake off his teammate Andrea Iannone, who in turn has done a pretty damn good job so far of disposing of the threat of Dani Pedrosa, who has not really made any significant inroads of late into the two Suzukis.
There is Jack Miller. He said that he had to keep it steady in the opening laps. He's done so far. The number 43 is there in eighth. Could do with a top 10 finish here. And there is Valentino Rossi just up behind him. Another 49.4 for him as he sits in ninth place.
Yeah, his teammate Maverick Vinales. If you're a Maverick Vinales fan, you might want to just switch the mute buttons on or turn your screens off for a quick second, because he's in 15th place at the moment, a 49.6 the last time around for Maverick Vinales. The pace is hotting up at the front. Andrea Dovizioso and Andrea Iannone, the two former Factory Ducati teammates, have dipped into the 148s again, a 148.934 traded with a 148.944 by Andrea Iannone. So Dovizioso, the marginally faster man in that lead quartet.
You just know what the situation is going to be with Vinales as well. We're going to get to about 10 laps into the race and all of his fastest laps are going to fly in. It's just too late constantly.
The battle for that coveted Rookie of the Year prize, Franco Morbidelli's just taken Hafiz Syahrin for 13th place. So that will increase Morbidelli's slender two-point advantage he has over the Malaysian to be crowned Rookie of the Year. Again, coming through turn number 11, we saw there from our long-distance camera, Alex Rins having more than a few nervy twitches on that rear tyre through that fast-sweeping left-hander.
Can I just make a quick shout-out to someone who we're unlikely to see? Jordi Torres, 1.1 seconds off his teammate for the weekend, Xavier Simeon.
Yeah, and the kudos of beating Xavier Simeon. That's going to keep him interested for the next half an hour or so, that's for sure. Yeah, top job by Jordi Torres throughout this weekend as we're on board with Marc Márquez. Very, very rare when you get conditions like this. Look at that clear blue skies, hardly any breeze around, absolutely baking up temperatures that Marc Márquez goes for that soft rear tyre. He's making it work so far.
Fastest lap of the race for Alex Rins in third, the number 42. He did an outstanding job of hanging on in there with soft rubber in Misano 2 weeks ago when many thought he would fade off outside the top 10. Now, let's watch this again. This is the replay from pole. He didn't get off the line well enough, and that's why he got pumped wide, because Márquez is going to show his front wheel in a moment. He braked a little early, deep for Márquez. To be fair, Márquez kind of put him off a bit there. He was so deep and late, and he just was offline and just tried to nudge on that power a bit too soon.
Let's have a listen, because we're going to hear a massive... That was a nasty, nasty high side. That was off throttle to me. He wasn't even on the gas, was he?
Fingers crossed he's OK. It's the fluids, of course, that he would have taken on in that race all pour out.
Well, you know, he was out a little bit wide with that kind of lead angle. Dirty part of the circuit, maybe. What is not up for any debate is Jorge Lorenzo is launching himself skywards at the very first corner. And as we say, there can't be many times in his career where he's had back-to-back poles and back-to-back DNFs.
Andrea Dovizioso, you underestimate him at your peril at the moment. He won at a circuit that he'd never won at before in Misano, and he's looking in really good shape here in Aragon. Ducati is a different package, but Dovizioso is a different rider these days. It was the 10th different circuit he'd won at in Misano, and all of a sudden the circuits that used to be Achilles heels for the Italian are starting to come up trumps. Just in the background there, really wide from one of the Alma Pramac Ducatis. Aleix Espargaró still in 6th place on that Aprilia.
Yeah, and he's still lapping in those low 149, Steve. A truly Herculean effort this from Aleix Espargaró. He said, I've been to a couple of his media debriefs this weekend, he's probably one of the most upbeat and positive characters I've ever met in my entire life, professionally and socially, Aleix Espargaró, and he is just such an upbeat guy. But even he said, my motivation is being really tested right now, it's been pushed to the absolute limit. I'm finding it hard just to turn up and ride this motorcycle, and there he is, hounding Dani Pedrosa on lap 10 of the Aragon Grand Prix, not far shy of half race distance, and he is only 2 seconds off the race win. He was here 1 year ago when he equaled Aprilia's best ever result, 6th place. He finished 6.9 seconds behind Marc Márquez at the chequered flag. That's the closest Aprilia have ever finished to the win. He may well be improving on that record he set here himself 1 year ago.
Dovizioso keeps threatening to pull away. Márquez is not letting him do it. And he just turns up the speed a bit. Still, Rins is tagging onto the back though, and then you get onto this back straight and a tenth or two has opened up once more.
Maverick Vinales is going to be salvaging a few more points if he carries on at the rate of knocks he's currently circulating, and he's 14th right now, Vinales. He's just behind Franco Morbidelli and Taka Nakagami, Bradley Smith and Zarco ahead of him, but he's lapping quite a bit quicker than that quartet in front of him is Vinales. On board again with Marc Márquez then. This is the first corner where Cal Crutchlow and Jorge Lorenzo have already bailed out of this Aragon Grand Prix.
Pretty much identical laps there coming from Márquez, Rins and Iannone.
Yeah, at this stage, Steve, this quartet look like they've got the better rhythm. Dani Pedrosa at the moment just struggling to hang in there with this top four. He was 0.3 slower than the trio immediately ahead of him, Dani Pedrosa. Conversely, he was a couple of tenths quicker than Aleix Espargaró, so he's got a bit of a buffer back to the Aprilia man by about half a second. Aleix Espargaró has got a bit of clear tarmac back to Danilo Petrucci, over a second to fend off, to hang on to that stunning top six.
Vizioso now heading around part of the circuit that he least favours. A long left-hander that leads you into turn number 12. Márquez there still in second of the two blue bikes. The two factory Suzukis. If you've just tuned in, Jorge Lorenzo from pole position crashed at turn one on the opening lap. That is two falls on the trot now for the number 99. Further down the order, this is Aleix Espargaró having a great ride on the Aprilia. Taka Nakagami's just gone up ahead of Joan Zarco for 11th. He's the leading the rookie chase at the moment. Good effort.
Brilliant performance by Taka Nakagami. He was really happy with his display last time out. Misano said it was the first race all year long where he didn't make a single mistake. He was able to keep his consistent rhythm throughout. Learned a lot more about how that motorcycle, that Honda, changes in race conditions as the tyre wear goes, as the fuel load lightens. He's locked in a really good dogfight here. Hunting down Bradley Smith and Franco Morbidelli leaves a bit of paint on Joan Zarco. They've done that before in Moto2, those two, haven't they?
Yeah, no love lost there between Morbidelli and Joan Zarco. Zarco's having a bit of a mare out there. He now falls back behind Maverick Vinales.
Yeah, he was pretty much nudged out wide, wasn't he, by Franco Morbidelli. So Vinales will probably feel like the best he can do is to get ahead of the three in front of him, Morbidelli, Nakagami and Smith. Well, in fact, it will be, because they are a good 5 seconds behind Valentino Rossi in ninth place. This is Bradley Smith in 10th.
The gap at the front has opened up to half a second for the first time in this race. Is this Dovizioso now just starting to turn it up? He's gone into the 48s. Now, he was consistently in the 48s in free practice four.
Yeah, Andrea Dovizioso is just edging us closer towards the kind of pace that we expected before the race. The predicted race pace ticker at the start of the race, a 1:48.5. We haven't really been anywhere near that, but if anybody can take us there into uncharted territory in this race, it will be Andrea Dovizioso.
And Marc Márquez desperately wants to win. He wants to stop this run from Ducati. He's sick of hearing the records being broken, but he is also aware that the man that leads this race is the man who is second in the championship. 5 points dropping on Dovizioso isn't a big deal for him. 25 points losing is, and it's a 48.385 from Andrea Dovizioso, and both Dovi and Márquez are showing what they've got now.
Well, what did we say? If anybody could take us into that predicted race pace zone, it would be the two top men. Andrea Dovizioso then fires in a blistering 1:48.385. That's over half a second quicker than anything else we've seen from anybody in this race. So Andrea Dovizioso putting Marc Márquez to the test here. Massive examination here of Marc Márquez's risk over reward ratio. Will he roll the dice? Will he try and go in hot pursuit of Andrea Dovizioso? Or will he put the shutters down? Will he lock it all down and protect his massive advantage in the World Championship?
Braking there from 293 kilometres an hour to 94 into turn one. Simon?
Guys, last night, Jack Miller and Cal Crutchlow said that the front tyre overheats in the slipstream, so it's quite a thing to manage, you know, when you want the slipstream to make the time down the back straight, but by doing that, the front tyre gets no air, overheats, and then doesn't have the grip. Apparently, the Honda has temperature sensors in the wheel, and they can, you know, have a warning light. Jack Miller confirmed that they have it, the same sort of thing on the bike, which works from pressure. Right now, I'm with the Michelin main man, Piero Taramasso. Piero, can you tell us how and why the grip drops off and it's not actually degradation? Can you tell us about that?
Yes, this is what happened when the track is very hot, the air is very hot, so you overheat the tire. When you overheat, you lose grip, so you lose the feeling in the front. If you stay in the jet stream, this is very, very bad. You can get 20 degrees more compared to the standard temperature. So what they have to do, the riders, is just go in the side or on the left or in the right, try to cool down the front tire.
Thank you, Pierre.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Well, excellent point made by Simon Nasty, but I think Marc Marquez would just love to try and get a slipstream off Andrejevic Josa, because he hasn't been able to get close enough.
Well,
although that said,
48.4 might say otherwise, that he's just posted. He is having a go, Matt. He is having a go.
Yes, tune your radio, get the Jaws music going, because here he comes.
Just saw there a moment ago, Jorge Lorenzo in the medical centre, possible dislocation of the first toe on the right foot for him. Now, Marquez is close.
Menacing
really
Marquez.
Close. These two had some epic scuffles in 2017, and it looks like it's going to be revisited here, because Marc Marquez is launching an assault.
That fastest lap of the race on the previous lap. Oh, Marc Marquez dives bomb Andrea Dovizioso at turn number 12. He's made it stick. We were on board with the Italian. And Marc Marquez does a number on 0-4, Andrea Dovizioso. A brilliant move by Marc Marquez now. Andrea Dovizioso is going to try and get in the slipstream here, is he? Can he just wind that Ducati up to top gear?
That got a bit scrappy there, didn't it, through the chicane for Andrea Dovizioso, when he's lost all of his momentum, so he's not going to be able to do it here into turn 16.
That's about as loose as you'll ever see Andrea Dovizioso, who is normally on rails, one of the smoothest riders in the championship. Now the exam question's being posed by Marc Marquez. We talked about his risk over reward ratio. Well, we know which way that pendulum has swung.
Both riders in the 49s there, but of course there was almost a bit of contact between them.
You see on that lap, the previous lap, Steve, Dovizioso did a 48.3, and then on the next lap he was almost 0.6 of a second slower. There you go. We said Marquez was starting to look menacing, and that's about as menacing as he gets. A brilliantly executed lunge up the inside of Andrea Dovizioso into turn 12. Now, when these two have locked horns in recent history, it has tended to be an outcome in favour of Andrea Dovizioso. Marc Marquez looking to exact a bit of revenge here.
Further back, Andrea Iannone is in third place now, ahead of Alex Rins in the battle for third between the factory Suzukis. Now then, Andrea Dovizioso has got to try and make the bus stop chicane a lot cleaner than it was before. They drop out of the reverse corkscrew. This part of the circuit is Marquez territory. We go past Marquez corner and look at the gap that Marc can open up there. But soon we enter sector four. Is this Marc Marquez saving his tyres at the start of the race? Is this him trying not to overheat that front and getting out front for a while just to give himself a bit of breather? Who knows?
He didn't leave himself open to exposure, did he, for that front tyre to get overheated in a slipstream. The minute that he got close enough to pounce and attack Andrea Dovizioso, well, the millisecond he got close enough, that was it. He took his opportunity. Now, can he break the toe of that super fast Ducati down the back straight? He can. Andrea Dovizioso not close enough to try and line up an attack coming into the braking zone for turn number 16.
Marc Marquez knows how quick these Ducatis are, but he probably knows as well that this is one of the best chances to beat the red bikes on home soil here in his beloved Aragon, the race winner here the last 2 years.
This is about as close as Ducati have been to winning in Aragon since Casey Stoner's success back in 2010. Andrea Iannone, at the moment, holds the bragging rights down at X-Star Suzuki, and he will want to beat Alex Rins. Oh, Dovizioso up into turn number four. You knew that was coming, though, from Marc Marquez on the cutback. Dovizioso got him at turn four. Marc Marquez strikes straight back through at turn number five.
on board now with Marc Marquez, and Dovizioso goes through again. That's neatly done, and he'll have the line as well. They're side by side, and Ian Oni's catching these two. He just put in his fastest lap of the race. He's in the 48, the Italian. And I tell you what, both of these guys, they do not want Andre Iannone invited to this party.
Potentially a bit of maniac mayhem coming their way. Andre Dovizioso then has got his gloves off. He's ready for another heavyweight showdown against Marc Marquez. They exchange a couple of overtakes already on this lap. Look at the defensive tight line that Andre Dovizioso runs into turn number 12 this time around. He wasn't going to let Marc Marquez have a sniff of moving up the inside this time around. And he knows. He's safe in the knowledge that the Ducati's got the upper hand coming out of turn number 15. It's got the better grunt, it's got the better acceleration, and undeniably, it's got the better top speed.
If Andre Iannone hangs on in here and gets his nose in this, it's an absolutely outstanding ride and one of the best of his career. He's doing a really good job. On the back straight we go. Marquez cannot get close enough to the Ducatis here. We now head up into turn 16, and Iannone was just slightly later on the brakes there on Marc Marquez. I'll keep check on Iannone's lap time when we come through. It's got to be in the 48s again.
Marc Marquez has had his nose bloodied a few times over the last 18 months by Andre Dovizioso. You know, he comes over the line and he is right in contention. Alex Rins right there as well. This titanic tussle between Marquez and Dovizioso is bringing the Suzuki man back into contact. You can see how hard Iannone's trying, though. He got in really, really hard at that first corner, didn't he?
Yeah, that didn't pay off too well, and that now means Alex Rins is back in contention as well. But the factory Suzukis are having a brilliant day so far. Dovizioso and Marquez. Marquez and Dovizioso. How many times have we said that over the last 18 months?
So this is a turn seven where last time around Andrea Dovizioso managed to force his way through up the inside of Marc Marquez's Repsolanda. They'll drop down hard on the brakes, tricky downhill braking zone for this reverse corkscrew. On board now with Marc Marquez coming through turn number 10. This is where he's had the corner named after him, left-handers. This is where he loves it so much. His dirt track background, Marc Marquez, he's so, so strong on anti-clockwise circuits. Great record at the Circuit of the Americas, great record at the Sachsenring. Dovizioso again deploys that really defensive tight line on the inside of turn number 12. He's learned his lesson, hasn't he, Andrea Dovizioso? They call him the professor. Well, even at his age, he's still able to take on board new tricks.
Yeah, he is. He's learns from his mistakes so quickly, does Andrea Dovizioso, as he now opens up the power of that Ducati onto the back straight.
You see, what he does know, Steve, if he runs that tight line at 12, he knows he's got Marc Marquez pretty much covered then onto the back straight, and he knows pretty much at the back of his mind that Marc Marquez's Honda is not going to be able to slipstream the Ducati down the back straight. Marc Marquez, you've got to say, again, he's right there racing the Ducati. He's always said it's such a hard bike to race because it's got great braking stability, and of course it's got great punch and poke coming out of the corners. It's a real tough motorcycle to try and calculate where you can make your move, where you can overtake, and more crucially, once you've made the pass, how you can fend them off as well.
Six laps remaining. At this stage of the race, I'm already surprised enough that the Suzukis are as close as they are. They are actually in contention here. This is a replay over at turn one of Dovizioso with that rear wheel in the air trying to stop.
That's what happens when you see 93 mm on your pit board plus zero. That's how hard you've got to push to keep Marc Marquez behind you.
Here we go again. This is turn 10, where Marquez is so strong. Dovizioso will surely take that defensive line as we approach turn 12 again. A few rehearsals going on. Marc Marquez has got to potentially work out a way of beating him after this, if this continues to go on.
He's just completely changed his line coming through turn number 11, then dropping in the braking zone for turn 12 was Andrea Dovizioso. Quick check a little bit further back behind this top four. Danny Pedrosa still in fifth place. Aleix Espargaró still in an outstanding sixth place, only 5.4 seconds behind Andrea Dovizioso. On board now, let's see this Ducati wind up through the gearbox, third, fourth, fifth, then clicking in the top gear, six, approaching about 330 kilometers an hour. And look at that, Marc Marquez. He loses three, four, five bike lengths on that acceleration point out of turn 15.
Five laps remain as the rear end of that Ducati wallows around. Across the line we go, 49.2 from both Dovizioso and Marquez are 49-1 from the Suzuki rider in third, Andrea Iannone.
Yeah, behind Aleix Espargaró is Petrucci in the middle of the two, Alma Pramit Ducatis, Valentino Rossi still ninth. Maverick Viñales has got himself inside that top 10, but he's a long way behind his Movistar Yamaha teammate, 5.5 seconds. So it looks like 9th and 10th, the best we'll see from the factory Yamahas, although Valentino Rossi's keeping Jack Miller pretty honest in that battle for 8th place. On board again then with Marc Marquez. This is at turn 7 where he lost the lead about 3 or 4 laps ago. An aggressive but fair move from Andrea Dovizioso.
Soft rear tyre hanging on in there at the moment. Through the reverse corkscrew we go. You get the feeling that if it was the last lap, there might be something happening through there. As we now go round turn 10, on board with Marc Marquez as he gets closer and closer to Andrea Dovizioso. He's a lot closer than he has been on the previous few laps, but again, that defensive line from Dovizioso, but the door's open and Marquez goes through. He can't stop it, surely, can he? He's on the curbs. Brilliantly done there from Marc Marquez, but look who's joined them.
Yeah, now right on the tail of Andrea Dovizioso, and he fights back. That's aggressive. Oh, they almost touch, and he's forced Marc Marquez wide. Marc Marquez comes back onto the track, but they're going to get him on the comeback. Oh, 3 abreast through turn number 15. Andrea Dovizioso, Andrea Iannone, and Marc Marquez. They were side by side, all three of them. For a brief second, the Suzuki man led it. Marc Marquez fights back, but it's Dovizioso that leads again. It's all out warfare here in Aragon.
Rins is coming as well. This is brilliant here in Aragon. Red bike, orange bike, blue bikes. This is fantastic. And Andrea Iannone just got a massive hello from Marc Marquez, who said, what on earth are you doing here? Cross the line we go. Brilliant racing and 4 laps to go. This is on.
4 laps to go. We don't want this one to end, do we? It's been breathtaking action so far over the first 19 laps. Over the line, just 3/10 of a second covering the top 4. And it's still Andrea Dovizioso. No way through for Marc Marquez coming through turn number 4. No way through for it. 2 by more. Is there? Yes, there is. Marc Marquez, that's brilliant. Has he run it a little bit hot? He has. He runs wide. Andrea Dovizioso swings straight back through.
This is fantastic stuff from Dovizioso and Marc Marquez. They've had some epic brawls in the past. And Marc Marquez wants to level the scores. Alex Rins put in his fastest lap last time off the 4, we should just point out. Through the reverse corkscrew we go. Will it be another pop at him now into turn 12? He tried it and it almost worked for Marc Marquez last time.
Well, the tight defensive line is not tight and defensive enough to hold off Marc Marquez down into turn number 12. What about this time around then? Dovizioso, he cuts an even tighter line on the inside. Marc Marquez, he's so tempted. He closes up in the braking zone right on Dovizioso's rear tyre. This is where Dovizioso took him last time around. Can Marquez exact revenge? No, he's not going to be close enough.
Through the bus stop chicane, left now onto the back straight. It is Ducati from Honda, from Suzuki. Rins just struggling on this lap to hold the pace. On the back straight, on board with the Ducati of Dovizioso, now looking towards Marc Marquez, who can just about stay in contention and was the fastest through the speed trap. Iannone's gone a bit hot into turn 16. Can he recover it?
Yeah, well, how will Marc Marquez's front tyre be now? He's been in the slipstream for a good few laps. Will that be overheating? That front tyre is attacking Dovizioso at the first corner. Leg dangling in the braking zone, and he's made it through. So Marc Marquez hits the front yet again. What can Andrea Dovizioso do to try and fight back?
Here we go uphill again. Dovizioso won't want to be in second for long. Surely he'll show his front wheel, and all the time this happened. Brilliant from Dovizioso. Andrea Iannone gets another bit closer, and he sits him up again. Is he going to be wide this time? No, Marquez through. Iannone's back again.
Well, Marquez and Dovizioso have exchanged a season's worth of overtakes between them already in this Aragon Grand Prix. And Andrea Iannone, he smells blood as well. He's trying to take Suzuki's first win since the British Grand Prix at Silverstone in 2016. That honour that day was Maverick Viñales, who's still down in 10th place. Back at the front then, Marc Marquez drops down through the reverse corkscrew. Can he turn the screw on Andrea Dovizioso? Can he end Ducati's domination of the MotoGP World Championship? Andrea Dovizioso, of course, fighting for Ducati's 4th straight victory in MotoGP for the first time in their history. He's fighting for a landmark 50th Grand Prix success for the Bologna factory, but Marc Marquez with vociferous and partisan support behind him, he's holding firm. 2.5 laps to go.
Through the bus stop chicane once more, Dovizioso will look to try and get that drive out of the last corner to try and pass him on the back straight. Still, the two Suzukis are just about in contention. There'll be two laps to go when we go past again, but this has been a really solid lap from Marc Marquez, and Dovizioso isn't close enough to pass him here on this lap. Round turn 16 then.
Has he done
Marquez
it?
Leads.
Has he done it? Has he finally broken the resolve, the determination of Dovizioso? Dovizioso is still going to have a big part to play in this one. There you go, plus 0-2. Marquez over the line then. We've got two laps to go here in Motorland Aragon. We've been treated to an absolute classic MotoGP encounter here. Classic racing, aggressive and hard, but fair racing at the front. Valentino Rossi has caught, and he will now find a way through on Jack Miller. So Valentino Rossi has come from 17th on the grid up into 8th place. Always Dovizioso getting really, really close there again to Marc Marquez. This is going to be like their famous showdowns in Motegi in the Red Bull Ring. Is it going to come down to a titanic tussle on that last lap, where in Japan and in that races last year, it was advantage to Andrea Dovizioso in both Australia, in Austria and Japan.
This is this part of the circuit where Marquez is so, so strong. Dovizioso has just got to try and get close enough to pounce onto the back straight through turn 11. Now breaking into turn 12, Marquez will leave it late here. And he's just got that leg dangling. He's pushing that front end as always through turn 12. Slightly wide on exit, but nothing to worry about. Marquez still with the upper hand. Quarter of a second in his back pocket at this stage.
Yeah, I mean, he had this gap last time around coming out of turn number 15, and Dovizioso was not able to get that Ducati close enough in the slipstream to hunt down Marc Marquez on the brakes going into the penultimate corner. Marc Marquez trying to break the toe of that missile GP18 behind him, and he has done so. What has Andrea Dovizioso got left? It's now or never for Dovizioso. There's just a lap and a corner left, and a Marc Marquez on the brink of one of his best victories of the season, on the brink of exacting revenge on Ducati and Andrea Dovizioso.
That was a good lap from Marquez, a 49 flat at this stage. One lap remains. It's now or never for Andrea Dovizioso. The two Suzukis, no matter what happens today, they've had an outstanding afternoon in Aragon. Can Dovizioso, though, in second, get close enough to challenge Marc Marquez? Sector one, it's so far so good for the number 93.
Dovizioso, nothing to lose. He's not fighting for the world championship. Just all he can do is try and pile the pressure on Marc Marquez. Can he push him into an error? Can he make Marc Marquez make a mistake? Marquez at the moment looking imperious, looking like he's on course for a third straight victory here in Motorland Aragon. He'll have one hand on the 2018 MotoGP title.
Neat and tidy out of the reverse corkscrew. Marquez looks like he's in the zone here. He's got his elbow down, he's got his shoulder down. Dovizioso can't get close enough. He's got to be closer than this if he wants to have a go.
Dovizioso just didn't quite have that rear tyre hooked up through turn number 11. These are three massive corners.
He's wide,
he got sucked in. That's it. Andrea Dovizioso was so desperate to try and get close enough to Marc Marquez to use the top speed of that factory Ducati. Marquez pushed him into that error. Andrea Dovizioso is going to have to give up the ghost. All he can do is shadow Marc Marquez. What a victory. A masterclass in Motorland from Marc Marquez. He has been absolutely awesome. Revenge is sweet.
He's been sick and tired of all the headlines about Ducati as he head round turn 16, but he's managed to stop the rot, and he ends this run for Ducati just before a record is broken. Marquez takes the hat-trick of victories in Aragon, and he wins to take control, and he says, yes, this is my championship. 72 points clear going into Thailand. And he said, what about that to Ducati?
Yeah, and what about that from this man, Aleix Espargaró, equaling Aprilia's best ever result in sixth place, just 9.3 seconds away at the chequered flag. Whew. Pause for breath after that one, ladies and gentlemen. 41 minutes and 55 seconds of pure theatre, pure drama from the best riders in the MotoGP World Championship. And for once, when it comes down to Marquez versus Dovizioso, it's the 93 that prevails, and he moves ever closer to the 2018 MotoGP World Title. It'll be his fifth Premier Class crown in 6 years, and it continues this remarkable streak every race since the Italian Grand Prix in Mugello. He's managed to increase that advantage in the championship. And of course, crucially, they've denied the Catti their own bit of history today. Andrea Dovizioso just 6/10 of a second away from the Catti's fourth straight win for the first time ever. And the wait for the Catti's 50th Grand Prix victory, well, that goes on to Thailand in Buriram in 2 weeks' time. But all you can do, Steve, is marvel at the marvellous Marc Marquez.
Well, it's not just about winning in Spain. It's not just about the fact that it's Aragon. It's the fact of what's happened recently, Ducati's domination. If Ducati win, it will be four on the trot. It'll be a record. Blah, blah, blah. He wants to everyone, he just wants to remind everyone, hang on a minute, I'm the world champion here and I am the championship leader, and he's done that. The Suzukis, I think, have been absolutely sensational today. It's great to see both of them up there. And the last two races, really strong performances from both Andrea Iannone and Alex Rins. Who would have predicted Andrea Iannone on the podium? He did have good pace.
In FP4, he demonstrated really, really strong pace. Andrea Iannone's first podium finish since the Spanish Grand Prix in Jerez. So he's enjoyed racing on Spanish soil this season, hasn't he? And a welcome return to the top six for Iannone. He'd been no higher than eighth in the last six races, although he's in his best point scoring run since 2015. And he continues that.
Shout out to Jordi Torres, by the way. He finished the race in 20th, half a second behind Xavier Simeon.
Yeah, top ride by Jordi Torres. Franco Morbidelli gains more ground over Hafishari in the battle for the Rookie of the Year. Morbidelli was 11th. Cyrene drifted outside of the points in 18th place. But here he is. This is Marc Marquez. Just to his left is a new monument. There it is. You can catch a quick glimpse of it. That turn 10 named after him. Alex Rins, close but no cigar for the second race in succession. Back-to-back fourth places for Alex Rins in front of his home crowd. A lot for him to be proud of, though, after his day's work.
Marc Marquez will revel in this. He really, really will.
First time Suzuki's had a podium finish here in Aragon.
Well, that, ladies and gentlemen, if you were keeping your hopes alive for something rather dramatic to come at the final stages of the championship, he had one hand on that world title. He's got one hand and a few fingers after this one.
Yeah, they've pretty much engraved his Christian name on there. I think they're about halfway through the surname now, aren't they? Here he is in front of his fan club. He celebrated there before. This is his third straight win here in Motorland Aragon. And what a performance. And again, Marc Marquez, he's not scared of making bold and brave decisions. He was pretty adamant. He came to the grid with that Michelin hard rear tyre. He could not have done too many laps in terms of race distance on the soft rear at all. But there he was, even though track temperatures were in the mid-40s, as always, he had the courage of his convictions to make that decision, stick with it, and boy, did he deliver.
Dovizioso, oh boy, did he fight. He led for so long, he just didn't have enough. He will be gutted, but it's the first time he's put together four podiums on the trot in his MotoGP career.
Yeah, first time since his, what, 250cc days back in 2007. Not a bad day at the office as well. He's equaled Casey Stoner's podium record now. 89 Premier Class podiums for Andrea Dovizioso. A richly deserved, rapturous reception for Alex Rins on his arrival back to the factory Suzuki garage. They'll be making their way down very quickly to Parc Fermé as well, because Andrea Iannone on the podium. But here's the man of the moment. Most wins with HRC across all classes. Marc Marquez now levels with the great late Mike the Bike Hailwood. He's only four now behind Jim Redmond. And Mick Doohan's all-time Honda winning record of 54. Well, with another two-year contract for Marc Marquez at Repsol Honda. Mighty Mick Doohan, the five times 500cc world champion, the Aussie legend, that tally will be looking fairly vulnerable very, very soon. Marquez, of course, averts the unwanted distinction of never having been on the podium in four races in a row without a win. Well, we can scratch that one out the stats for now.
Yeah, I think that maybe you should just stick to the riding. The dancing ain't all that. But Marc Marquez celebrates with his team and crew. That will mean so much to them.
Yeah, his moves on Andrea Dovizioso on the circuit, somewhat better than his moves in Parc Fermé.
He's seriously pumped.
Oh, yeah, yeah. It's like this whole Ducati domination was starting to, not consume him, but he was getting, like you said, a bit tired and a bit weary. Of, like, oh, Mark, how are you going to beat Ducati? Yeah, Ducati's got the best bike now. How close can you be to Jorge Lorenzo and Andrea Dovizioso? He wanted that one so badly. Takeo Yokoyama there. All the senior bosses from HRC, no wonder he's got a massive smile on his face. We may well see, depending on what happens in Thailand in Buriram, Marc Marquez have his first match point to be crowned 2018 MotoGP World Champion right in Honda's backyard at the Twin Rim Motegi in Japan, a circuit built and owned by Honda. No better place for him to win the title. He's had to work mighty hard for that one. It has been absolutely scorching hot conditions out there today.
Shouldn't forget, he opted for the soft rear tyre as well.
And it was a last minute decision, wasn't it, as well?
Andrea Iannone, well, hats off, sir. Hats off. There have been questions asked about his mentality from everyone, really. This was the moment. This is the one, wasn't it? This was the big move. Hot into turn 12 was Marquez, just on the curbs. Dovizioso tries to have a look around the outside. It doesn't happen. Then Dovizioso comes through on turn 14, up the inside. They touch, tries a block pass. Marquez goes off circuit, has the inside line. And Andrea Iannone then momentarily leads, going onto the back straight.
I'd love to get a freeze frame of that overhead shot. This is on lap 19. This was how tight it was. There were still four laps of racing to go. How tight was that?
That was an attempt at a block pass that just didn't quite pan out. I don't think any of them expected to see Andrea Iannone.
And then all of a sudden, Marc Marquez finding himself in an Italian sandwich. Brilliant.
A great race. Really, really great race. And they're always better when you come out on top. A top five for Dani Pedrosa. That's his first since Catalunya. And he steadily climbs up through the points tables. By the way, Valentino Rossi's eighth place actually extends his advantage in third in the championship over Jorge Lorenzo, of course, crashed out turn one. Still no further updates at the moment on his fitness after that crash at turn one.
Yeah, just the fourth top six finish of the year then for Dani Pedrosa. Well, the fans flocking towards the exits. They will not be able to say they didn't get their money's worth today, certainly from MotoGP. And what about this ride? What a top ride by Aleix Espargaró. A top six finish here in Motorland Aragon after a season of woes. He said only yesterday, I cannot wait for 2018 to be over. And here he is. His prediction pre-race was, well, I think at best I'll be 12th. And that's optimistic. And he's in the top six. And of course, riding for the Fausto Grazzini team, he is classed as an independent team rider. If you're wondering why a factory Aprilia rider is in Parc Fermé, well, his team status means that he is classed as the top independent team rider. And who's going to begrudge him that one after such a rousing ride?
Danilo Petrucci found the going tough in the end. It was hot out there. It is his best result in Aragon.
He looks like he's just been sat in full leathers 24 hours in the sauna, doesn't he, Danilo Petrucci? Here comes the maniac then. What a show he delivered. He wasn't quite able to go with Marc Marquez and Andrea Dovizioso at the end, but Andrea Iannone on the podium for the first time since Jerez. It's Suzuki's first ever podium here in Motorland Aragon. He's down in Parc Fermé with Simon. Let's hear all about it.
Fantastic ride, Andrea. Before the race, did you think a podium was possible?
Yeah. So for sure in case Hawk, don't make a mistake, don't crash. So for sure it's a little bit more difficult because also him have a very good pace, but Hawk start with soft tire on the rear and I think it's really critical condition. I not push for the four part race, from the beginning to the half race I not push at my maximum, and I think this is a really good strategy. And at the end I have some tenth more than Alex, and I follow Dovi and Mark, and at the end we take this podium. It's really good for me, for us. We work really well during this week, and thanks Suzuki, thanks all the people who work with me.
Congratulations.
Yeah, what that does is shuts up a lot of people who said that he can't ride once he's out of a contract with a team, and that is the biggest result he's had since he found out, of course, he was leaving. And fair play to him. This was the drama, and I thought that Andrea Iannone and Marquez had touched, but they weren't far away at top speed.
Yeah, I was going to say, that was all that unfolding at 300 kilometres an hour. First podium then in a long time, as we said, the Spanish Grand Prix. He's still got one more chance to get a podium in Spain again this season in Valencia. Of course, at the final round of the championship, which will loom large on the horizon after we have our four overseas races. Here comes Andrea Dovizioso. Well, today was not his day. So often in the past, when it's come down to a Dovizioso versus Marquez battle, it's been the Italian that has prevailed. Today, though, he has to settle for second place behind Marc Marquez. Let's see what he thinks about it down in Parc Fermé with Simon.
Andrea, that was a great fight with Mark. You kept the pressure on him right till the end. How do you feel?
Really happy, really happy. I mean, in Aragon, always we came here and we struggled a lot. And we in the past we saw the podium from very far. So now we were fighting for the victory. Unfortunately, we couldn't get it, but Mark is very strong here. I mean, the real surprise is we are fighting with Mark. So I'm so happy about the work we did during this season to come here in this situation, in this moment of the championship, very strong. In our bad track, we are fighting for the victory. So this is good for this championship and also for the future.
Congratulations, Andrea.
Yeah, Andrea Dovizioso did always say that this Aragon track, which has been a bogey circuit for Ducati, would be a bit of an acid test of the progress they have made, although they did come here and test and have a bit of a base setting already dialed into that GP18, and Marc Marquez wasn't at that test as well.
You know, it's quite funny though, isn't it? Because in some of the duels they've had in the past where Marc has lost out, he's always said, well, this was a Ducati track, so we're happy to be second, and look what's happened. The tables have turned.
Yeah, Marc Marquez will be absolutely loving this, wouldn't he? Victorious in front of his home crowd as he crossed the line, even in our commentary box position, I could hear massive roars and cheers from the grandstands opposite the start-finish straight here. Marc Marquez will shortly hear from him coming over to talk to Simon Crafar in Parc Fermé after his 113th career podium. Marc Marquez then, he's in the best podium run since 2014. Seven podiums now in a row for Marc Marquez. Boy, did he have to work hard for it today, but he's back on the top step of the podium at his beloved Motorland Aragon. He's talking to Simon down in Parc Fermé.
A big thank you for the entertainment, Marc. It looked like you were 100% all in today.
Yeah. Today, you know, I take a risk, I take a gamble, I put the soft rear tire, because during the weekend, every time when I put the hard, I felt okay, but I didn't feel good, you know, and then sometimes I put the hard one to be safe, but today I say, okay, I take a risk, I was riding really good, really smooth in the beginning. I was able to follow Andrea in a good way, and then we were fighting in the end, a great fight, really. Some movement in the limit. I was on the one time in the green. I mean, I was completely in the limit, but okay, I enjoyed a lot, and thanks to all these people, because you know, it's really warm, and I know that it's hard to be there on the grandstand. So thanks and gracias to Aragon.
Big congratulations, Mark.
Yeah, thanks to Aragon. It has been kind to him in the past. What a weekend for Marc Marquez. It all started with the ceremony on Thursday, turn 10, named after him. He's bookended the weekend with a truly stunning victory. The first time actually he's won from third place on the grid in over a year, Misano. last time when he fended off the Ducatis that day, Petrucci and Dovizioso, in that rain lash San Marino Grand Prix.
Can confirm, of course, that with Dovizioso finishing second, Marc Marquez cannot now win the championship in Thailand in 2 weeks' time. He almost certainly can win it in Japan, which I'm sure that he, the team and the factory won't mind so much. But Thailand, it can't be done at.
Yeah, and this is no surprise at all if you've been following us over the last few races, which we hope you have been. Defeat today for Yamaha does mean now that it is their worst losing streak in well over 40 years.
Valentino Rossi might argue that only finishing 15 seconds behind isn't quite as bad as it could have been, but that's still nowhere near where Yamaha factory bikes need to be, so I do know what you say.
That's what it means to Marc Marquez to take a victory at Motorland Aragon. And not only a victory, but another giant leap towards the 2018 MotoGP title. We saw the vast majority of those motorcycles piling into the circuit from about 6 a.m. this morning. 62,000 fans have been treated to some top-notch two-wheeled entertainment here in Aragon. The very famous and distinctive Aragon Wall Trophy is about to be handed over to HRC and Repsol Honda, and Marc Marquez and the two Andreas, the former Ducati teammates. Here's the Suzuki man. Then Suzuki have never had a podium finish here in Aragon before today, and they have both of their bikes inside the top four. Here comes Andrea Dovizioso. Wait for a huge reception for Marc Marquez after another famous battling victory. Crew chief Santi Hernandez there in the middle. I haven't seen Marquez this pumped after a victory for quite some time, but he's absolutely jubilant. The CEO of Telefonica Spain handing over the constructor trophy then to HRC. Will they be able to lift the rider championship when we get to Motegi in a few weeks' time? Andrea Iannone will receive his third place trophy from Jorge Viejas, the FIM board member. Andrea Iannone then, third place for him, the 29-year-old from Vasto in Italy. It's his 34th career podium. His 10th in the MotoGP World Championship, so he moves into double figures of rostrum finishes. Andrea Dovizioso, the 32-year-old from Forlì in Italy, and his 289th Grand Prix start. Marta Gaston, Motorland Aragon president, doing the honours of handing over the trophy. His 89th podium is level with Casey Stoner in terms of career podiums, edging ever close to the half century in MotoGP. That's podium number 48 in the Premier class for Andrea Dovizioso. But he moves ever closer to retaining his world championship. Javier Lamban, the president of Aragon, he'll be delighted to be handing over the victory trophy to Marc Marquez. His 113th career podium, his 41st win in the MotoGP World Championship. It's a Marquez masterclass in Motorland.
Very, very happy Marc Marquez. That might just rank up there, you know, as one of his finest victories, given the circumstances of Ducati's recent domination we'll get to find out soon because we get to ask him the questions. But certainly from the emotions that he's shown since crossing the line as the race winner, it'll be almost certainly in that top five because it was a brilliant, brilliant race. He did take risks, not just with that soft rear tyre last minute, but in the race as well. He was willing to sacrifice the 25 points if necessary, but it didn't happen. He went on to win. A good move and a clever move in the end, Matt, because we did see over the last 24 hours with the other front tyres, he was looking a touch fragile in places.
Yeah, he was. Yeah, but look at that. That picture speaks a thousand words, doesn't it, for Marc Márquez? Great scenes. Both of us are going to be fortunate enough to talk to him in a few short moments after this race. Going to be really excited to see what he said. He did admit, didn't he, it was a big risk to go for that soft rear tyre.